So we are done with electrolysis. Electrolysis होता क्या है, and we did a good number of examples understanding कि what the products will be, हम किस type का electrolyte लेंगे and electrodes क्या होंगे, medium क्या होगा. We did all of that. We did enough number of examples there. We are moving to the next topic, laws of electrolysis. I've used this image just as a reminder to what we did previously. Electrolysis of aqueous NaCl. As you can see, the products are cathode pe hydrogen gas release ho raha hai and anode pe chlorine gas release ho raha hai. Right? This you have done in detail in the previous presentation. So let's continue with the laws of electrolysis. Now, what happened? Michael Faraday, the man, in 1833. He tried to study the relationship between the amount of substance liberated. Now we know electrolysis hota kya hai. Electrolyte aapne liya and finally you get the products which are liberated at their respective electrodes. To study the quantitative relationship, that kitna amount of substance is liberated at the electrode during electrolysis and the amount of current passed kya hota hai, kitni current hum pass karenge aur utni current pass karne ke baad what will be the amount of substance liberated. This quantitative relationship was studied by Michael Faraday in 1833 and he gave us two laws summarizing his whole study, and he gave us two laws which are known as Faraday's laws of electrolysis. The first one, Faraday's first law of electrolysis, a very simple statement as written here. The amount of chemical reaction and hence the mass of any substance deposited or liberated. यहाँ पे liberate कितना amount होगा किसी substance का, it is directly dependent on the rate of the reaction, what kind of a reaction takes place of that of the electrolyte. Thus, that amount of reaction and hence the mass of any substance deposited or liberated at any electrode is directly proportional to the quantity of electricity. सोल्यूशन आप ले लें, एक्वस सोल्यूशन ले लें या आप मोल्टन स्टेट में इलेक्ट्रोलाइट ले लें, कितना अमाउंट डिपॉजिट होगा, इट इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द क्वांटिटी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो दैट अगर डब्ल्यू ग्राम ऑफ द सब्सटेंस इज डिपॉजिटेड ऑन पासिंग क्यू कूलम्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, देन डब्ल्यू अकॉर्डिंग टू द फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोलिसिस इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू क्यू. राइट? और वी कैन राइट डब्ल्यू इज इक्वल टू जेड क्यू. वॉट इज दिस जेड? A very important constant. I have told you it many times that constants ki definitions alag aati hai, constant alag se define karna aana chahiye. The Z is the constant of proportionality here and it is known as electrochemical equivalent of the substance deposited. Electrochemical equivalent of the substance deposited on its respective electrode. Now if I amperes of current is passed for T seconds, Q की जगह हम लिख सकते हैं I into T. Coulombs, electricity in coulombs is equal to current in amperes multiplied by time in seconds. Thus we can rewrite this equation W is equal to Z into Q की जगह हम I into T लिखेंगे. Now if one coulomb of electricity is passed or you're passing one ampere of current for 1 second, then if all of these are 1, in this equation Q is 1, in this equation I and I is 1, T is 1, then W is equal to Z. Now from this equation W is equal to Z, you are able to, you will be able to define electrochemical equivalent, so that you define it as this. The electrochemical equivalent of a substance is defined as the mass of the substance. Z is equal to W. What is W? W gram of the substance was deposited. Thus, it is the mass of the substance deposited when? When current of 1 ampere is passed for 1 second. Or in terms of electricity, aap kehna chah rahe ho, or when 1 coulomb of electricity is passed. This W becomes equal to Z, or Z becomes equal to W. This is the first law of electrolysis, that W is equal to ZQ, and taking each of these quantities as 1, W is equal to Z. The second law, Faraday's second law of electrolysis. In this we take a series of electrolytes. They're connected together with a source. We have AgNO3 in one electrolyte, in one electrolytic cell, copper sulfate in another, H2SO4 in another. This law states that When the same quantity, you're taking different electrolytes, they're connected together, but the quantity of electricity passed through them is the same. The law states that when the same quantity of electricity is passed through solutions of different electrolytes connected in a series, then what happens? Then the masses of the substances produced at the electrodes are directly proportional to their equivalent weights, right? Then relationship kya hoga? Jo mass deposit hoga us substance ka, it will be directly proportional to its equivalent weight. Right? What is equivalent weight? You have done it already in solutions. It is that mass of the substance which can combine with or it can displace 1.008 gram of hydrogen or 8 grams of oxygen or 35.5 grams of chlorine. Ek baar ye revision karna pade, to go back to solutions. Wahan maine aapko bataya hua hai equivalent weight kya hota hai. So going back to the law, what is it? That if we do this, we connect a series of solution, series of electrolytic cells, and then pass the same amount of electricity through them, then W1 will be dependent, will be proportional to E1, W2 will be proportional to E2, W3 will be proportional to E3, etc., etc. In the equation, we have considered just two, right? Amount of the quantity of the substance 1 deposited on its electrode is proportional to equivalent weight of that substance, right? Now what is W? According to the first law of this Faraday, first law of electrolysis, W is ZIT. In this equation we have substituted the same value, or W ki jaga humne likha W1 ki jaga Z1IT divided by Z2IT is equal to E1 by E2. Now ITIT will get cancelled, hence according to Faraday's second law of electrolysis, Z1 by Z2 is E1 by E2, right? The electrochemical equivalent of the first substance divided by the electrochemical equivalent of the second substance is equal to the equivalent weight of the first substance divided by the equivalent weight of the second substance. This is Faraday's second law of electrolysis. Now before we draw the final conclusions, let's take one more look at the quantitative aspect of electrolysis. Quantitatively, sari cheezein kaise related hoti hai electrolysis mein. To understand this aspect, we consider a very simple equation, electrolysis of molten NaCl, right? If you remember, NaCl will give you sodium, apne aapke cathode pe release hoga, jab molten hum lenge, sodium will be released at cathode and chlorine ion hoga, ek molecule mein se half chlorine. Chlorine gas as such is released at anode. Now what does this whole thing mean? Na plus takes up one electron and gives us sodium. It means that to produce one sodium atom, one electron will be used. We'll need one electron to produce one sodium atom. Thus, very proportional result, passage of one mole of electrons, agar hamare paas honge, it will produce one mole of sodium. Right? बिल्कुल प्रोपोर्शनल रिजल्ट है. एक इलेक्ट्रॉन अगर एक सोडियम एटम दे रहा है, एक मोल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल गिव अस वन मोल ऑफ सोडियम. व्हाट इज मोल? मोल इज अ वेरी सिंपल डेफिनेशन, आपने 11th में भी की है. अ मोल ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस इज डिफाइंड एज द 6.022 × 10²³ नंबर ऑफ पार्टिकल्स, एवोगाड्रोस नंबर. वो पार्टिकल्स एटम्स हो सकते हैं, मोल्स हो सकते हैं, आयन्स हो सकते हैं, मॉलिक्यूल्स हो सकते हैं, आयन्स हो सकते हैं. सिमिलरली क्लोरीन में क्या होता है? क्लोरीन गिव्स अवे वन इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड वन एटम इज फॉर्म्ड, सो दैट दो क्लोराइड आयन्स जब दो इलेक्ट्रॉन्स लूज करेंगे, दे विल गिव अस वन मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ क्लोरीन गैस. एंड वी कंक्लूड दैट टू मोल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल प्रोड्यूस वन मोल ऑफ क्लोरीन गैस. इन दिस इक्वेशन आर क्वांटिटेटिव एनालिसिस इज दैट वन मोल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विल प्रोड्यूस वन मोल ऑफ सोडियम and two moles of electrons will produce one mole of chlorine gas. Now we know the charge of one electron. We can very easily calculate the charge of one mole of electrons. How? By multiplying charge of one electron, which is 1.6021 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs, multiply it with Avogadro's number because we're taking one mole. This comes equal to 96487 coulombs. जिसको राउंड किया गया हुआ है अप्रोक्सीमेट कैलकुलेशंस के लिए 96500 कूलम पर मोल. This quantity, 96500 coulomb per mole, is known as Faraday. 1 Faraday is equal to 96500 coulombs per mole, and Faraday is represented by capital F, right? Thus, if we study the quantitative aspect of electrolysis, we reach to the final conclusion, which is, if n electrons are involved in the electrode reaction, अभी तक जितनी भी आपने reactions करी, you will apply this conclusion to all of them. What is that conclusion? If n electrons are involved in the electrode reaction, the passage of n Faradays of electricity will liberate 1 mole of the substance. Right? What is it? It's a quantitative aspect. कितना electricity pass करने पे कितना amount of substance liberate होगा. So this is the conclusion. I'll read it again. If n electrons are involved in the electrode reaction and the passage of n Faradays, 1 Faraday is 96500, n Faradays will be n into 96500. Utna passage of electricity karoge, then it will liberate 1 mole of the substance. Ye yaad rakhna, ye hume numericals mein use hoga. After that, in terms of gram equivalence, agar aap yehi baat kahoge, yehi conclusion aap in terms of gram equivalence kaise kahoge? 1 Faraday of electricity deposits 1 gram equivalent of the substance. Much easier to remember. 1 Faraday deposits 1 gram equivalent of the substance. Whereas, if you pass n Faradays, you will get 1 mole of the substance. Right? Now finally, the important conclusions of both the laws. We are in this presentation, we had 2 laws, Faraday's first law of electrolysis and Faraday's second law of electrolysis. Then we studied the quantitative aspect. Let's conclude. Let's have the result of all of this study in this last slide. When 1 Faraday of electricity is passed, 1 gram equivalent of the substance is deposited. Thus, the electrochemical equivalent, which I told you right in the beginning that it's a very important constant, then the electrochemical equivalent can be calculated from the equivalent weights as Q, because Z is equal to equivalent weight of the substance divided by 96500. We already know 1 Faraday deposits 1 gram equivalent. That is why we can use this equation. Z of a substance, electrochemical equivalent of a substance, is equivalent weight of that substance divided by 96500, which is the value of 1 Faraday. Then, knowing the weight of the substance deposited, W gram ka value hume pata hoga, on passing a definite quantity of electricity, which is Q coulombs, the equivalent weight of the substance can be calculated. They are interrelated, everything. Now, if you know W and you know Q, you can calculate the equivalent weight of that substance by this equation. Equivalent weight of the substance which was deposited on the electrode because of the electrolysis is equal to W, its weight, divided by Q, aapne kitna quantity of electricity pass kiya, multiplied by 96500. So here, when we found the value of Faraday, when we calculated the value of Faraday, you can see wherever we can use it. We can use it in so many places. So actually what happens, agar aapko quantity of electricity pata hai, Q pata hai, you know the current in amperes, you know the time kitna in seconds, you can calculate the quantity of electricity. Knowing that, knowing the quantity of electricity, you can calculate the amount of the substance deposited, right? Final line, knowing the quantity of electricity passed, the amount of the substance deposited can be calculated. Right, we'll do the numericals of this. We'll have to do the numericals based on the laws and the quantitative analysis, quantitative relationships. We'll do them in Google Classroom.